Alright, alright, what the hell is going on? My procrastination has paid off. Once more, I feel like I'm kind of just set, like never actually doing anything for my programming class. So, what happened here is I have a bunch of side things that I do. It doesn't have anything to do with schoolwork. They're basically just personal projects, I suppose. Personal challenges for myself in order to kind of like challenge myself creatively, and then also it's also a programming thing, but it also requires me to like think about game design, how I would go about something. Let me tell you, man, it is a challenging prospect to come up with like compelling, interesting quest mechanics. That's a whole other conversation, but I'm just saying, like, that's the kind of stuff that I'm thinking of. Like, what would, if I was creating a game, just give myself a bubble, like a tiny section of like a full-blown game, how would I design it, what would I put in it, what would I do with it? And let me fucking tell you, man, it is hard to come up with something that is like truly compelling, that isn't just boiled down to go get this, go fight this, come back here, and then go do this. And it's just like, it's a very difficult thing to come up with something that's like truly both rewarding and challenging at the same time. So like, the moment you get into it, you start to understand. Now granted, there are a lot of game developers that just put stuff in, like it pads the game content, it lengthens the game thanks to this being in there, but it's not fun padding. It's there to be there rather than there to actually add something to the experience. And I would never, if I was a game developer and I had full control over what gets in and what doesn't, I would never put something in that I couldn't figure out a way to make it truly both interesting and relevant to the overall game. Like, it's something that adds. It's pure and simple. There's a lot of things that are in games that it's just there as something to do and like either get experience, maybe you get like a skill or something, but it doesn't really add anything to the overall game. You could take that out of the game and you would not be missing anything. There wouldn't be anything that people would think, man, I really wish that had been part of this game. And so like, I would definitely be the kind of person that's like, if I think of something like that I want to add to a game, but I can't turn it, twist it into something interesting, I would never add it. I don't know why the fuck I went off on that big ass tangent, but that's the kind of stuff that I'm working on, trying to conceptualize things. And it's difficult. It's fucking hard. I don't like it. And it definitely speaks to why games take as long as they do. Good games take as long as they do to effectively make, because like, just, it's honestly more difficult to conceptualize something than it is to code it. Animation obviously is always a big thing, but like with animation, again, you know exactly, you don't know exactly what you're doing, but you have a very solid baseline to start working from. Whereas, you know, like when you're trying to create something, you're starting from the ground up and you're just going in. And it's no fucking wonder that almost everything that comes out now is like a sequel. Or at least, you know, the ones with big budgets that need to see a return. It's a sequel that reuses assets and shit like that, and it's obvious why. It's fucking daunting to, you know, like, put all of your effort into something new. But that's the other thing, like, that's my biggest complaint with the, how games work. Because to make them, you need money from people that are not strictly gamers. You need money from CEOs, businessmen, stock market people, people that only have the dollar signs in their eyes. They couldn't care less about everything to do with games. And those are the kind of people that are basically running the AAA game formula now. So it's obvious why nothing really good is coming out from big studios lately. Because the end game is always what can make us the most money versus what makes the best game. And those are two very different things. But anyway, enough of that. I wanted to talk about this game. I want to talk about this game critically for a moment. I kind of hit on it in the last video a little bit. in that, the negatives, why I didn't pick up this game in the first place, and just to kind of reiterate it and hopefully say it in better terms. The number one reason is I feel like the damage per combo is basically universal. Like, there is a very obvious baseline that you should be looking for with all of your combos, and it doesn't really deviate from that at all. And that kind of irritates me a little bit. It's not a big thing, because it's just something you have to get used to, and it's not a game breaker, obviously, but it is definitely something where it's just kind of like, every character is capable of this off of any hit confirm, so what's the point of, like, really trying to go for riskier hit confirms when the most you're going to get is, like, maybe 500 more damage versus other games where you're getting, like, twice the combo damage if you go for, like, a risky read for a fatal counter or something like that. But anyway, it's not a huge thing. My biggest problem was, like I said, how there were certain characters. Let me actually just hop in here, because I was going to do survival mode. I've done all three of these, and I was hoping one of them would be like the general arc system works stuff where you're fighting like superpowered versions, and unfortunately none of them are like that. But you look at a character, I don't know much about Hyde. I do not know a damn thing about Ori. I know enough about Merkava. I know very, very little about Seth. I think Seth is considered one of the worst characters in the game, right? Hilda's in the mid-range. I don't know a damn thing about her. She uses like a yo-yo or some shit. He's a close-range brawler. I know a little bit about him. He's another very strong pressure character. I don't know a damn thing about him. That's the character Lord Knight uses. That's the extent of my knowledge of that character. That's the character Lord Knight uses. I don't know a damn thing about her. Obviously, that's the character I'm going to know the most about. I know a little bit about this guy because there are a few people that use him, and I don't know a damn thing about her. But out of the characters that I do know, look at the characters that I do know about. Waldstein, Merkava, let's see, Yuzuriha, Gordo, slightly Carmine, kind of. He has a few projectiles that kind of work this way, but you just look at the top three, Gordo, Merkava, and Waldstein. All three of those characters have moves that can hit you from like three quarters of the screen. Oh, also Yuzuriha, that's her, I won't remember that. All of those characters have moves that will hit you from like three quarters of the screen away, and they get a full confirm off of it, all of them. And so it very obviously elevates these characters above all of the rest, and then the rest are just, you know, whatever. They're average, they're bad, wherever they are, it is obvious they are not on the same level. And even her, to an extent, it just doesn't, this is really only the top three. She's just another character that can almost kind of compete with them, because she does have some sword moves that can hit from that distance. But overall, these three characters are by far and away the best in the game because of their capabilities. And that's what got me, is how you have such a huge gap between the quality thanks to the neutral game differences. And that kind of design irritates me on a base level, because you just have this obvious hurdle you have to go over just for picking a certain character. Because you didn't like one of these three top characters, you are already starting out from a position of weakness in comparison to these three. And so anytime you run into these three, now your job is that much harder. And obviously in a fighting game, people are playing to win. People are going to pick these three characters. It doesn't help that these three characters are all interesting as well. It's not like none of these characters are like boring or dull, or just like there's no real reason to pick them aside from their top tierness. Like, look at Kokonoe. Kokonoe is a character that has nothing compelling about her to me. There is absolutely nothing that draws me to that character, and the only reason I would bother playing that character would be because she was so much better than everybody else. If I was looking at it from an aspect of, I want to win, I will pick this character. That's what a lot of people did. There were swarms of Kokonoe everywhere in CP 1.0. Then she got nerfed in 1.1, and it kind of started to die down. There were still plenty of them, because she was still definitely top three, arguably still the best, but she didn't have her bullshit that basically made it impossible to compete with her unless you picked like six characters. And so all of these people, especially now in Extend, where she has been hit even harder, and now the top characters are, who's considered top? I think Pazuma, New 13, and Falkenhayn are considered the best now. Pazuma and Falkenhayn, of course, what a fucking shocker. I think those are considered, those three are considered the best in the game right now. Now you almost never see Kokonoe anymore. Like, almost every tournament that I would watch from, you know, like, what Jordal would post or whoever would post, there would be a ton of Kokonoes. Now Kokonoe is almost non-existent. And that's kind of my argument, where, like, I would pick all three of these. Well, not really Waldstein, because I hate this dude. His fucking, those arms are stupid, they bug me. They irritate me. I don't know why, I don't have an argument for why. It's just, those irritate me. They're ridiculous. I would not pick him because of them. But I would pick Merkava. I would definitely play Merkava. Out of the characters I've seen on here, I would play Merkava, Seth, and Gordo, I think. Yeah. I'd probably try her. Just because, you know, redhead. I always gotta pick the redhead. Does he count? I don't think it counts if they're male, but why not? I mean, Carmine does seem interesting too. But out of all of them, I would say maybe Hyde. Nah, not Hyde. Hyde looks too much like you. I probably wouldn't pick him. So yeah, I would try Seth. That's probably it. Seth, Gordo, Merkava, and just based upon aesthetics. Not based upon anything, not knowing anything about their game plan. Just based upon aesthetics, I would try those four characters. So I definitely understand, like, that the only reason to pick these characters isn't just... I don't know why I just started this, because I still have more to talk about. There's more to talk about than that. But yeah, so anyway, the entire point there, just so I can move on to the next point, is that they aren't top-tier characters for the sake of being top-tier. They are all interesting, and I can understand why people would pick them outside of just being top-tier. But those were the two main reasons why I was iffy on playing this game, on getting this game in the first place. And why I knew for a fact I was not going to import it. But now that I have played it, now that I do know a little bit about it, mostly thanks to Monsieur Blue Steel, thank you for that comment explaining all of the D button purposes. I greatly appreciate that. I would have had to look it up otherwise. And we all know how goddamn lazy I am. So I would have probably just like gone never knowing how to do that rapid cancel shit. Yeah, so anyway, point being, thank you very much, Blue Steel. Your efforts are appreciated quite a bit. So I understand a little bit more about the game now, and I have played enough Gordo to understand how, in general, like, how he works, and I can kind of surmise from that's how most of the cast works. This is the type of fighting game that I talked about when I started Guilty Gear. Nothing is difficult for the sake of being difficult. You can get by without doing optimal. I mean, like, there is more optimal shit that I could be doing. I do need to practice some of it. There's some stuff I need to work on to see if I can't make combos, certain confirms, easier for myself. Versus, you know, the combos that you've seen me drop like 700 times now in two videos. And so there are certain things I still need to work on, but at its very base, at the base level, I have B&Bs off of every single confirm that I may have to cut short. I'm not going to be getting optimal damage off of them because, like I said, the other ones do require effort. But I can work from a baseline and play. Just play the game. That's all I want to do is play the game. I can play this game with a certain base of knowledge that doesn't require a ton of effort to get to. And then while I'm playing, I can work on building myself up. I can improve from that baseline while playing. I don't have to sit in training mode for hours just to learn a character's basic initial combo that will allow me to actually play the game against people. And that is what Guilty Gear doesn't have. Guilty Gear does not have anything that's just, you can do this right from the get-go. You can play this game and start having fun with it right away. No, you need to put effort into a game. You need to struggle. You need frustration, you need all of this shit, just in order to be able to play a game where there is more frustration awaiting you because you have to learn matchups, you have to learn neutral, you have to learn other characters' gimmicks, because obviously you're not going to learn every character in the cast and know everything about them right away. So, fighting games just have... There's a lot of frustration inherent in the genre. Pure and simple. Because you are going to lose a hell of a lot more than you're going to win at the start. Just because... not really a hell of a lot more, but the chances of you going on and just, like, right away dominating everybody are basically null. It's not gonna happen in a fighting game. It just won't. I don't care how good you are still going to struggle at the very start to learn matchups. You're gonna lose to, like, very gimmicky characters from the get-go. And there's frustration in that. And you just have to understand, like, this isn't because this game is bullshit. This isn't because this other player is bullshit. This isn't, you know, there's no real reason for the frustration. It's just, you know, nobody likes to lose. But it's an inherent aspect of fighting games. And so to add on executional frustration as well, you're just piling blocks up and up and up and further up, and eventually there's a tipping point where it all comes crashing down. And that's the last thing you want when you're creating a game that you want people to buy and play and compete with and continue playing and want to invest in future versions of the game or other games that you create. The last thing you want is to have a reputation of you're gonna have to sell your life away in order to be able to play this game, because there's nothing else except for a massive time investment that will allow you to actually play this game. And this game doesn't have that. This game, you can just play it and have fun. That's it. It's such a fucking, like, just saying it. It's so simple. It's so easy to comprehend, and yet it's lost in so many different fighting games. I would say, like, the very borderline of this aspect would be King of Fighters 13. And that's only because there is such a massive gap between somebody that can understand and execute within the game mechanics and somebody who's just starting out. Like, there is absolutely no... In Street Fighter, for instance. When you're first starting out, you can't scrub out a win against, like, an average player. It's gonna happen. You're not, like, completely revolving around a bunch of, like, really complicated setups. Reversals are a hell of a lot better in Street Fighter 4 than they are in King of Fighters 13. There are just a lot of game aspects in Street Fighter that make it easier to win at a low level than a game like King of Fighters 13. But I also feel like King of Fighters 13 is not so executionally difficult that you can't see the light at the end of the tunnel. It's definitely a very borderline thing, and this is all coming from a point of view, my point of view. Versus, I know there are plenty of people who just look at King of Fighters 13 and they're like, nah, fuck that. Screw it, I don't care, it's too difficult. I don't want to deal with all these different jumps. I don't want to deal with the rapid fire combos you have to do to confirm this kind of stuff. I'm not gonna deal. I know that there are people that feel differently than I do in regard to King of Fighters 13. But it's still just... Like, Guilty Gear is definitely a game that... I feel like with every fighting game that comes out lately, I am approaching it from a point of view of wanting to like it. I really want to make this game work for me, and then I struggle to make it work for me, even though when I understand from the very start that it's just not going to. And that's kind of how Guilty Gear is. And playing this game has definitely kind of hammered that point in with a certain finality that, like, you're never going to enjoy Guilty Gear for what it is. It's not, you want it to be something else, but that's not what it is. And you're not going to enjoy it as it is. So I think that's kind of, I don't know. I have to at least give it one more shot with a character that isn't Potemkin. Because starting out from a point of using a bottom tier character is not going to give you a positive outlook on the game if you don't also like that bottom tier character. So I do have to give it another cursory run through to see whether or not I am absolutely positive that's how I want to view that game. But so far things are not looking up, versus, like I said, I'm enjoying this game. I can play this game and have fun with it and just truly enjoy myself. And we'll see whether or not that lasts once I actually really start playing against other people, since obviously I have 2 matches against other people, but I really am enjoying myself. Bitch! Enjoying myself is still shit in the word. Oops. Oops. Oops.
see.
I've hit a point where I know what combos I want to use, I know what combos I want to do, but I'm not at the point yet where I actually hit the correct buttons to do them. Oops! Because the first time I hit C2, but I didn't have the meter. The fuck? Oops. Oh, I was hoping he was just gonna be a training dummy. There we go! Oh shit, I did the wrong combo. That was the combo I wanted to do, because that's one of the things I want to work on. So you saw me fucking up constantly the JB 2 hits into JC. I want to see if it is possible. To do JB, JC. Are we close enough? I don't think so. I haven't worked on the combo enough to remember the muscle memory. I need to do 3C22B. 3C22B. I also need to figure out a certain mechanic. I think you can only like OTG once per combo. So like for instance, I was trying on this, how that smashes them into the ground, and so like this will not work. Yeah, okay, that has to be how it works. Damn it. Bitch, don't jump over me, I got shit to do in the corner here. Okay, that definitely didn't work. But I also might have done it late. That's what I want. I want to test number one if I can do a 2C there instead of a 2B into 5C. Or maybe I can do 2B into 2C. I'm going to try that. Yes. What the fuck? That just sucks. Shit. This combo's too hard. Damn it. Why do I require timing to do things? I don't want it to require timing. I'll just be able to do it. Ah, motherfucker. Steam has another big sale on a bunch of games. Let me check this shit out. What is on here that I may want to get? Wait, why the fuck? Hang on a second. Why the fuck is that? Must be a pre-order. Witcher 3 isn't out yet, right? Okay, yeah, May 19th. That's weird, they're having a sale on a pre-order? Let me just check through this, let me see. Why do you have... These games are all on sale! Let me list, like, 10 games that are not on sale at all. So I'm just checking this shit. There is, there's only 3 games on here that are over 60% off that I have on my wish list, but I think I am going to just stop buying things. Like, unless it's a ridiculously good price. Like, let's see, it's this close. Hell no, it's not. Wow, I was not, like, seriously, I'm not even close. I need to learn jumping stuff. Because it doesn't seem like this guy has a jumping cross-up move. But I'm curious how effective trying to do something like as a throw bait, doing something like this would be. Oops. Like that. Doing that shit. It looks like I think I would have to rapid cancel it to actually get a combo. Damn it! What am I doing? It's still too far away to go follow up. I was hoping, I thought maybe I could salvage that by doing that move. But nope. No, I could not. I mean, that's the one thing I still need to... There are obviously combos that I need to work on. And block streams also are going to be a big thing eventually, like this shit. Special cancel that, which I missed. Well, that's another thing that I wanted to do. I can't believe you can special cancel that. That definitely didn't work.
Oh,
Oh shit, that was supposed to kill her! That's what I get, I should've just kept going. I should've just kept going, I thought for sure that would kill. It didn't. But yeah, so getting proper confirms off of his overhead is obviously a big one, because that gives me mix-up. Learning to properly utilize this shit. And not getting that. Yeah. So that's another thing I need to work on. Ensuring I go back to neutral. God damn, how am I fucking that up all of a sudden? Yeah, it is a little saddening that there's no, like... Oh, I thought I was being clever right there, but no, there is no being clever with the AI. I love it. I have so many games on my wish list now that I don't even remember what happened with fucking arms. Shit! Why are games so hard? I didn't hit you, pal. Who the fuck are you? Where the hell did Night Dude come from?
Final close. Divide.
How dare you back up? Stay in range so I can beat you up, please. Shit, how do I miss that? That's another thing I really need to get used to doing. Confirming by, Actually, I want to see, can you cancel that at all? Bitch. I need to stop getting hit, or you do heal, but very little.
Final close. Divide.
Fast enough. I really wish. Cause that's fast. Bitch. I don't think I should ever do 2-2-C. I feel like if I'm gonna do a super, I should do either Grim Reaper or the other one. That's the other thing, actually, you can make. Oops, I didn't want to do that. I was gonna say, you can make B Grim Reaper. Safe? Oh god damn, I'm almost dead. I am dead. Did a lot of- His Grim just did 2.3k? Are you serious? Sure thing, why not? I'm probably like 9 billionth. And the red, does it show me? No, it doesn't. That's bullshit, why the fuck don't you show me? Asshole, show me where I'm at! I guess I'm gonna have to go to network mode. And then... How many? Damn, oh, never mind. Well, I guess it depends on how that works. Whether or not that is, damn, look at that, Unraveled Bacon, 92% wins, good going. But it depends whether or not this is just, it resets at the start of every month. So obviously there's only been 5 days in March for this to have been brought up. Or if that is like just the past 30 days period. So how many? So we're looking at like 6,000 game at like the max, a little bit around there. This dude has a little bit more than that, 6,500. Damn, go Penthouse. Is that, I think that's one of the names that was in like one of the first lobbies that I went to. There's some people with some good win percentages up in there. Actually, nobody up here so far has less than 50%, which is surprising. That's the lowest we've seen so far, is 50. Damn. I'm sorry. That's a shit. These are cut. Now it's getting a little. Now we're seeing some sad moments. Oh, man. I just don't know how I can handle that. Like, I've never been. I think the worst I ever had ranked-wise in terms of just, like, actual playing was Marvel vs. Capcom 3, because I was terrible at the start of that game. I was absolutely god-awful when I first... Oh, actually, you know what I want to do? I want to check this out yet. I want to go to training mode and try to figure out... I want to try to figure out a better confirm for that combo, because I cannot make... I cannot make 2B into 3C... Or 2B... Sorry, not 2B. 2B, 5C... JB, JC, 3C work. I cannot get it. They always tech out before they're low enough to get hit by 3C. So I want to see what I can do. That was my whole way, doesn't it? Okay. Bitch! Bitch! Okay, I jumped away too much. Oops, that didn't work. Bitch! Bitch! Okay, now you're just doing this to piss me. Damn it, that wasn't what I wanted. I stopped letting, I let go a bit too early. Motherfucker. Damn, I did it again. My muscle memory is killing me. What the fuck? Damn it! I let it go, then I tried to get back in. That looked like it might work. I didn't think. I thought I had fucked up the 2C, and so I didn't jump into it very early. But that looks like it worked. But it won't work. Maybe I can make it work. I was gonna say, because I'm OTG'ing already. But I'm OTG'ing off of that move. So I can't OTG twice in a combo if I understand this game's mechanics. Shit! I might have just been late. I promise I won't make you guys sit there too much. One more attempt past to get the charge. JC. Okay, it doesn't look like that's gonna work. Can you super jump in this game? No, you can't. So yeah, it definitely doesn't look like that's gonna work. Damn, she got a weird hitbox. That's another thing. See, like, that didn't work. That OTG right there didn't work. So I have to work on something. Oops. I'm fucking that up as often as I am. Yeah, that definitely doesn't work. I wonder if that isn't a better way to do it, though. Off of just the first hit, and then jump cancel that. Because if they stay lower, so I feel like that would be... Shit, should I try that? I think that'll actually work better. That's something that I might want to try. But the other thing is, I saw you could do... Okay, never mind, not off of that. So how were they doing that? They were doing... Oh, you know what they were doing? Oops. It was that move they were somehow doing. I think they had to be up higher, like I had to have been doing the 2B on them in the air. But they were doing a charged JC into a JAJB combo. That's what I've been trying to do, because I figured doing that will allow them to fall lower while I am still falling down. I need to figure that out, whether or not that'll be. I guess I can still do that well, unless I fuck it up. Because I did, I mean, it, the easy mode version of it. I say easy mode, but fucking up the parts. Oh, I fucked it up. But you can do 5B into that anterior grab fairly easily. Like that. That's the easy mode version, but it's not the max damage version. And so I'm trying to get the max damage version of it. But I can't do it. Maybe I should just do... So can I combo? I definitely like combo off that shit. I get decent damage off of that, and that definitely looks like I can expand that further. So I'm kind of just curious. Like, can I do it? Yes, I fucking can. So yeah, I'm very curious. Oh. We're figuring stuff out. That's definitely something like if I think somebody's gonna expect command grab or they're gonna like mash a low button or something. That's definitely something I'm gonna do. Oops. I don't know why I should do that. But yeah, that's okay, so yeah, that's definitely a real possibility. I'm figuring things out, I'm doing stuff. This. Dang. Dang. Can I follow that up? Hang on. So there's a lot of unsecable time here. Oh, no, doesn't look like it. Oh, maybe is that what orange means? Orange means like it's unsecable, but you can't hit them during it? Because I don't think I've not noticed orange before. Anyway, I'm going to stop there. God, I've rambled and done random shit for long enough. But yeah, so I'm figuring things out, and it's a game that, like, I enjoy figuring things out, because there's no, like... There's nothing that's stopping me from figuring this stuff out. There's nothing that's like, oh, I can't figure this out because executionally I can't get that far. That's what I don't like about that. Because if you just do that normally, they'll fall all the way to well, almost all the way to the ground. But they tech early on when that happens. They tech. You know what I should do? Looks like that might work. I think that'll work. That also means. I'm safe, like I confirm that, basically. Damn it! The last thing I want to figure out on camera. And then I should stop procrastinating as I always do. Why can I not do this all of a sudden? Like, it's irritating me because the character moves a bit, but they don't actually do the move I'm trying to do. Alright, that may be tight. That may not actually be possible. I may be operating under a pipe dream here. I may just want to do something like that instead. The thing I need to figure out, for reals though... So that definitely didn't fucking work. That's what... Can you... Maybe that's what I want to do. Hang on. Maybe that's not possible mystery. I need to figure out how to confirm this mystery. without trying to just go into. Maybe I do just need to go into this main screen. Fuck. Damn it. I keep forgetting that move exists. Yeah, maybe I just need to do that mid-screen, I guess. That seems like... Because I don't feel like I'm confirming. Yeah, see, like, that's maybe... You think I can air dash into that? Because there is a decent amount of untech time there. So what was I doing? Because you can hit buttons fairly soon after that, and I think I can just do that by hitting D, right? Or 4D. So maybe if I just do like boom, 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 maybe. Damn it. I will never remember I hit the wrong button. I will never remember that shit. I will get that so often expecting overhead and be like, wait, what the fuck just happened? It's inevitable. Damn, I missed it. I'm just not used to trying to hit the button yet. I may actually be better at it by just actually trying to dash. One more try and I'm done. Okay, I'm gonna stop. Bye. Thank you for watching.